or you can vote in person on September 10th. Now, you don't have to bring your voter ID card in because the city says they have all of your information in a database. As you can see, the stink bugs crawl up this base here because they're attracted to the scent coming from this collection box. And once they're up in this area, they're going to crawl through a hole in this trap, go through that cone, and then the USDA will come here about one time a week to see how many stink bugs are in each of these traps. Piles of paperwork that need to be completed due to thousands of federal workers being furloughed here for a week. $6 would buy you these two TV dinners here, which only have about 500 calories in them.
She has a big beagle.
She's about 15 pounds overweight, so I'm definitely getting my workout in. Now, the warning period for that red light camera behind me ends on October 15th. The Frederick Rescue Mission served about 150,000 people last year.
Says, I can't wait to see what the future holds for us. Just saw that.
Jennifer Sisler often goes through a scrapbook of the memories she made with her soulmate, Lamont Ellis.
It's a piece of them. You have memories, but to hold on to something physical of theirs, it really brings on a different meaning.
These flowers in her kitchen have a different meaning because they're from Lamont's funeral. The 36-year-old father of three was murdered in Frederick on September 30th, 2012. Sisler and Lamont have a son together, Jaden, who's now 2 years old.
I'm just doing the best I can, you know, to keep myself going, to keep my son going, and I have the voice in my head of Lamont saying, you know, make sure you take care of my son, and that's what he would want.
Ellis was shot to death right here in Mullenix Alley. Now, police believe someone saw something that night or knows something about the crime, and they're asking anyone with information to come forward. Police say Ellis was out with friends in Frederick when he was attacked and killed.
We have evidence that we're still examining. We're still in the process. There was a lot of evidence that was sent out. And a lot of evidence that came back. So we still are going through evidence at this time.
Investigators don't have a reason to believe Ellis knew his killer, but they and Ellis's family are hoping someone else does.
I just want someone, honestly, to come forward. I feel like someone knows something, and for his family, for his children, for his friends, we need the justice for him.
Reporting in Frederick County, Maryland, Dawn White, WHAG News. Western Maryland is known for its quaint downtown areas, its many farming families, and its majestic views, but some think the region has little in common with the rest of the state.
We have irreconcilable differences, and we want an amicable divorce.
Scott Strelzik is the organizer of the Western Maryland Initiative. The group's Facebook page has gotten around 5,000 likes in just 2 months. Strelzik would like to see Maryland's 5 western counties, Garrett, Allegheny, Washington, Frederick, and Carroll, become the state of Western Maryland.
Our political society doesn't reflect our values and how we wish to be governed, so we're choosing to say we don't want to be a part of this one. We'd rather create a new one.
150 years ago, a group of Virginia counties broke off to form what's known today as West Virginia. And organizers say they'll move forward and try to make Western Maryland a state if they get enough positive feedback from residents. The idea received mixed feedback in downtown Frederick.
The needs of the people in the rural areas of the state of Maryland are entirely different than the needs of the people in the suburban and urban settings.
I am strongly in favor of people taking advantage of their constitutional rights.
It makes me kind of laugh, the whole idea of this. It seems kind of silly.
The U.S. Constitution allows for secession, but Congress and the Maryland General Assembly would need to approve it.
There's no magic to 50 states, right? We had 40 states and 30 states and 20 states. So what's wrong with 55 or 75 or 100 states where people can better live in communities, political societies, to reflect their needs?
Strelzik says the next steps are holding public hearings and organizing a website in hopes of making rural Western Maryland the 51st state in the country. Reporting in Frederick County, Maryland, Dawn White, WHAG News.
Don't stay there.
Although their memories he would probably rather forget, U.S. Navy Seaman First Class David Ezra will never shake his vivid memories of World War II, witnessing men lose their lives in the Pacific Ocean.
The two things that they call torpedoes got past them, and it hit ship right next to us. It jarred us, but wasn't nobody saved.
But thanks to the help of some local volunteers, he will make some more peaceful memories here in his home. Habitat for Humanity of Frederick County and Phoenix Rising are sprucing up Ezra's home for their September 11th program.
The front was in bad shape.
The veteran says his 7th Street home hasn't been worked on since 1966.
Well, I'm glad to see him. I am. I'm glad to see he's nice, good looking. I got to say that, good looking. And he's a hard worker, young man.
Tony, the owner of Phoenix Rising, is one of the most patriotic people you'll meet. And for us to get involved with a project like this, it's really something special.
Volunteers are painting David's porch here. Then they'll replace both of these posts. And finally, they'll replace all of those windows up on the second floor.
It's an honor to do a project like this for a veteran, especially on September 11th. All of our fallen heroes that sacrificed for us.
And now volunteers are coming together to help Ezra, who believes everyone is young at heart.
I call everybody young, including all them over there.
It may just be a coat of fresh paint, but to this 88-year-old veteran, seeing these volunteers on September 11th makes his home look as young as he feels at heart. Reporting in Frederick, Dawn White, WHAG News.